Hello and welcome to the Digital Pub Club. Brad, are you there?
I'm here. It wouldn't be the craft beer channel if we didn't have some slight technical.
That's certainly true. So we had some minor technical issues towards the end of what we were doing there. We thought we'd try and fix a small issue and instead created a giant issue.
Classic.
Pretty much the story of our lives, I'd say. But I think we're all live.
And the world right now, Johnny. And the world right now.
So, guys, let us know if you can hear what we're saying and see what we're doing. I can already see somebody saying an error occurred, which I think might become a quite common refrain during this pub quiz. But everyone else seems to be saying it's working. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I realise that there's probably about another 10 pub quizzes happening online at this very moment, just in London.
So thank you for being loyal and sticking with us.
Exactly, yeah. Yes. So we've got an amazing quiz that Brad and I have worked very hard on, and hopefully a cool way of doing it. We'll see. It's cool now, but like we say, we tend to over-engineer and try to fix things that aren't broken. So we'll see if it actually does work. But yeah, we'll get to that in a second. We've got a link to share with you, which will take you to the pub quiz for the day. Before we get to that, we'd love to know what everybody's drinking. Brad, what are you drinking?
Well, I've come dressed for the apocalypse in my camouflage attire. Yeah. And I thought, you know, I need something that's going to chill me out because I'm feeling incredibly anxious. So I've got some CBD beer.
Why did you struggle for the word beer there, Brad?
I've already been drinking. Ah. So I've got Highland Suntan CBD, which we tasted it in a video recently. It tastes like Highland Suntan, which is great.
Yeah, I'm on the same. Although it was technically Payload Pale we had in the video, but they do CBD of all their beers. Oh,
true, that's true.
We're chilling out with some CBD. I did actually, I wanted to open this live show by drinking a Corona.
Oh, damn.
And, in Sainsbury's, they had no Corona. So there was that.
Counter to all the videos I'm watching on the internet. Where all the shelves are empty apart from all the frigging Coronas.
Yeah, I know. People don't quite understand how this is transmitted, which is probably why they're all still out there pretending nothing's happening. I'm on the Highland Suntan as well, chilling out with my CBD. I've got some snacks. Unfortunately, my local independent shop didn't have some pub snacks for me either. So I've got a non-independent snack, but lots of independent beer just to the right of me.
Nice.
Before we get stuck into the real fun and start going into the comments that are coming out here, we should just say that my beautiful girlfriend Heather is sat to my right. I struggled with that because the cameras are flipped, so I'm getting confused. And she'll be helping us out with the comments, helping us out with social while this is happening, because we have an unbelievable 230 people online at the moment. To put that in context, we usually peak at about 70 to 80. So huge thanks for you guys coming on.
So what you're saying, Johnny, is it only took the apocalypse to get some of our people watching our show.
It was a long game we played all that time in China. No, I'm not going to start making these kind of jokes.
I thanks guys for tuning in. Hopefully this is entertaining, maybe okay compared to Netflix. I don't know. I know I've been Netflixing a lot.
There's
right
a
now,
t-shirt so. Right there. Craft Beer Channel, okay, compared to Netflix. Right, let's dig into the comments. The pub quiz will be starting at 5:30. We're just going to check all the technicalities are working, which they seem to be right now. And then we'll go live at 8:30. I think we'll have even more people joining us for that. So let's dig into the comments. Glen Affric Brewery have quite rightly pointed out that my beautiful girlfriend is my beautiful fiancé. Humble apologies. Ooh. What else have we got? Everyone's drinking Steady Rolling Man. I had one before this.
Nice.
Their bigger brewery is clearly paying off. Let's have a look at what I mean. It's amazing the variation we get. Somebody's drinking a homebrew that's a Boddington mild clone from the early 1900s. James Samford. Ooh. Yes.
I was actually from my fridge of wonder. I've got one of your homebrews, Johnny. I've got your pail that you gave me a while ago.
I've brought one along as well. We can drink that together.
Let's do that. I'll have to run off and get it in a minute, but we should do that, totally.
That's okay. That's okay. You leave me. It's good. I put that one in my little stash next to me because that's going to be paired with my beer snack later.
Nice.
So it's all feeding in. Somebody's drinking Heady Topper. Well, gel.
Oh. Oh. Wow. Good.
Or maybe he lives there, yeah.
Maybe he lives
there. Could be. Stone Cold Cream Austin. Nearly a pun. So nearly a pun, that one.
Lovely stuff.
Ice cream in a can. That sounds delicious. Vibrant Forest, Faithful Steed, Buxton. Always good to see Buxton being drunk. Somebody's drinking a Bailey's. I respect that.
Ooh.
You know?
I kind of respect that
it's
too.
It's a Christmas Day classic.
What do you think about all these? They've made Baileys, but like loads of different flavour Baileys. I'm not sure how
I mean,
feel
for
about
us, in the craft beer world with our pastry starts, for us to start calling out Baileys for putting extra flavouring in would be pretty
<That's true>.
Rich.
It's true.
We've got some brewers in the house, which is very exciting. We've got Glen Affric, we've got Verdant, we've got Stuart from Yonder. It's great to have some industry people in. I'd love to know what they're drinking, whether they're dipping into their own stash or cracking out something from their favourite breweries. Do let us know. Somebody's on Bissell Swish. Lots of New England stuff coming in. That's exciting.
Oh, wow.
Treehouse? You guys are ballers. Ooh. Blimey. I mean, I've got some delicious stuff, but nothing that would set the internet on fire like those would. Somebody's resorted to Famous Grouse. I hope you mean you've resorted to that brand, not that level of alcohol. I've also got about 7 barley wines to my left that might be cracked out depending on how this goes.
Have you? I've got some very strong Belgium stuff.
Are you going to bring out your secret shame, Brad?
Oh. I don't know how long we're going to be doing this for, so I thought I might keep the secret shame for the next episode. Because it's not going to taste any worse, basically.
No, sure. It is, I think, 4 years old now, and it is a double IPA. We won't say any more than that. So that's, at best, it's going to be a barley wine. At worst, it's going to be awful.
Do you think it's worth any money if I was to sort of try and sell it on the black market?
Hey, we could try that, Brad. We could we could announce what it is and see if anybody wants to buy one.
Okay, let's do that. Maybe. Okay, and then we'll just drink.
Go
it
on
anyway.
There, Brad. Tell us what it is.
Okay. So somehow I don't know how this happened, and I'm apologizing already for it, but somehow Cloudwater Dipper V3 got secreted in the back of my cupboard, and I don't know how many years ago that was. It was obviously from a shoot. Somehow we didn't drink it on a shoot, or I just bought it and forgot about it. So I've got it. It's sitting in my fridge. I just got it out the other day.
It's a bottled double IPA from Cloudwater.
Yeah.
Let us know in the comments what you'd pay for one of those. I'm assuming you'd have to be paid to drink it, to be honest, at this point. But yeah, there we go.
Sometimes
I'm enjoying it. Yeah, it's tasting right, really good, really dry. It's nice to have really dry beer. Dry beer's coming back. That said, my entire stash for the rest of the evening is Imperial Stouts and New England IPAs. And a triple fruited Gotha. And my homebrew, a coffee and... Gosh, what did I put? Hazelnut. Coffee and hazelnut porter.
Wow.
That's what my stash is looking like. I think it's about time we explain how the quiz is going to work.
Yes.
And explain what you need to do to get involved. So what's going to happen now is I'm going to copy and paste a link into the comments and hope that the comments allow that, which is something I've just thought about. and what needs to happen is you guys need to click that link, and that will take you to the place where you guys are going to be entering your answers. Now, before I post that link, we need to explain that there needs to be some honesty at play.
No cheating, you big cheaters.
Yeah. So we can't police whether you're Googling stuff. We've tried to design the quiz so it's very tough to Google it. But it's quite possible to cheat on some of the rounds. So please, please don't. I know there is the sexiest of prizes up for grabs, which is is a signed beer school. What side are my beer schools? A signed beer school right here. So this is our first book released in 2016. Full of wonderful, wonderful things, like a graph of when hops are added, all designed by Brad. What else have we got? There were some sexy spreads in here, and I've lost them.
Yeah.
It's because they were sorts of that.
Yeah, there's all sorts. Glassware. Look at those guys. Blimey,
how to
nice.
Taste a beer. Signed edition of that book is the prize for whoever wins the quiz. We've got 28 questions for you. We've got a general knowledge true or false round.
I quite like this this picture, Johnny. A very, very young-looking you and a very fat and hairy me. So,
Brad,
I don't know. I think hopefully it's a slight improvement over years.
I'm aging like a fine double IPA in the fridge, I assure you. That was super nerdy. I apologize. We're trying to keep this. We don't know who's sort of joining us. We were in timeout, so we could have some people that have never been on a YouTube live stream, never watched a beer channel. And to those people, I apologize profusely. But yeah.
I don't know if my director was time out, and I've never thought to ask him to put us in time out. But when you said we were in time out, I was like, okay. I might be on the cover of time out next week, actually. I'm talking to Brian about
that.
So anyway, that's a bit hush-hush, I think, maybe.
Well, it's lucky 275 people aren't watching.
Yeah, it's okay. Brian might be watching. He put it on his Facebook, so I'm sure it's fine. he was like, no, if you're in time out, I guess... He hasn't got time to read it. He's probably too busy designing.
I like that they're now calling it time in.
Yeah, time in,
that's
yeah.
Pretty clever. Just diving into the comments again quickly, I can see that Adam Robertson, when I said, what are you drinking, has put up a picture of hand gel. There is a brewery in America that was putting commercial cleaning fluid into cans and selling them.
Eh?
And they weren't changing the labels on the can. So it said like lager on the can, but it was cleaning fluid so intense it would kill you if you drank it.
What? Why were they doing this? They wanted to murder
people? I don't know
if they
thought it was a joke or whether they thought they were being helpful. I'll give you one guess which state in America they're from.
I mean, the fact that you've said that makes me assume it's Florida.
It is Florida.
I didn't know it was Florida.
Also, hilariously...
I fucking love Florida. Florida's great, by the way.
We had a lot of fun there, but...
You know, all that Florida man stuff is definitely true,
100%.
But it's also amazing, Florida.
Gloriously, the brewery that's doing it is called Darwin Brewing, so clearly not so evolved. Okay.
I see. Well, there's the Darwin Awards.
Yeah, exactly,
The most stupid death is probably drinking their bloody beer.
Well, I don't think you could blame the person cracking a can called lager, thinking, oh, I'll have this lovely lager in it, turning out to be bloody caustic acid.
No.
There we go.
Talking of cleaning products, though, and all the rest of it, BrewDog for doing their, turning their distillery into producing cider.
Yeah.
You know, we've all got to do our bit these days, so, you know. Props
to them. Absolutely. About halfway through, we're going to be talking about all the amazing stuff that brewers, pubs, companies have been doing, giving shout out to some people and also saying where you can get hold of great beer that goes to good causes. So we'll give some shout outs, including to BrewDog again, because they're doing some other cool stuff further down the line. I'm just enjoying the comments. I've just clocked that as soon as I said I'll give you one guess which state, we just got a bunch of people putting Florida. I think Florida knows what it is as well. Maybe the people doing those things don't know what they're doing, but most people know.
Is Florida the new Wild West? Is it like where all the outlaws go? Outlaws and old people. So it's just a bit, just the craze. It's just, is that why? Is it?
I think
it's all moved west. It's gone from west and it's just gone sort of down.
I think maybe, or maybe they're just a showier kind of idiot. I don't know.
It's about as far away from the rest of America as you can get, though, isn't it? Because it's right the way down.
Yeah, sort of the penis that hangs off of America, yeah.
lovely.
Yeah, you're welcome. I also, somebody's flagged the fact that I said sexy spread, which is not a nice phrase. So I apologize for that.
Oh,
So these things are just going to slip out. Oh, dear.
Is that another one?
Oh, shush. We can't go down this road. Right.
Can I just say, Johnny, it's very odd because I'm looking at my screen just at myself because you've turned off the ability for me to see you.
I have.
This is very disjointed. I'm just staring at myself. I feel like I'm talking to myself.
I'm trying to save bandwidth. Do you need to see me, Brad?
It's kind of weird. It is kind of weird not being able to see you. Can you turn it on and see if it fucks it?
All right. Bear with us for 1 second while we just deal with this tiny little technical thing. Hey, Bradley. Let's see how it goes. See how the computer works. Stop, you flirt. Yeah, it just had flagged to me the fact that somebody said that Florida is God's waiting room. That's amazing. Florida, because you've got to sell meth somewhere. I feel like we're going to lose some Florida viewers if we keep going down this road. We did. When we were in St. Pete's, that is an amazing place with amazing people. And I'm sure there are other parts of Florida with the same. Yeah. Right. Okay. So it's definitely pub quiz time. Brad, you have frozen, as far as I can tell from the live stream. Just have to be weird. Let's hope that Brad unfreezes at some point during this live show. Not yet. You're still frozen. I mean, now I wasn't pretending to be frozen. You're back. Back for you. Okay. Well, let's. Oh yeah, you're back. Okay. Right. Let's. Well, don't think too much about that. Everyone's RIP, Brad. Somebody said we're getting no audio from you, Brad. Apparently you've gone very quiet, Brad. Let us know if you can hear Brad. This, everything was fine until you said, "Hey Johnny, I want to see you." Nobody wants to see my beautiful face. Brad, take your headphones out. Try that. Okay, let's see if that helps. We'll have to wait and see. We need to get on with the quiz if we can. So we're coming up to 5:30, so I'm now going to post the pub quiz for now. So let's check that this works. Hopefully the link is clickable.
No cheating, anybody.
Okay, so that link is now in. You should be able to see it running away from you in the comments. I'll be posting it again in a couple of minutes for some new people coming in. Somebody's saying everything was fine until we insulted the good state of Florida. That's probably what happened. Bradley, I'm wondering whether you should hang up the Skype call and redial back in. I'll be able to stay live because I'm not coming in through Skype.
Okay. I'll see you in
Brad's going to be back. Bear with us. Apologies for the technical issues. I'm going to post that link again while we wait for Brad to come back in. Bradley.
Hey.
Okay. Let's see if we're going to get some sound from you now. Brad has dialed back in. Let us know, guys, if you can hear him now. We've done the turn it off and turn it on again trick. If that doesn't work, then who knows what will work? The world's in chaos.
We've got a musical round, Johnny, and I'm the most unmusical person in the world, so you need to be able to hear me as loud as possible.
Okay, apparently people can hear a bit of you. But I think you are a little bit quiet. So if you can, get louder.
I'll talk louder.
Oh, Brad has just taken over the entire screen. I'm sorry, Florida. Come on. Like, you don't need to be so mean. We didn't mean to do anything. We didn't mean any of it, right? We were just merely saying that occasionally you guys do some weird stuff. Right, so I'm fixing live. You can see me trying to fix the situation. Yeah. Right, guys, can you hear Brad? If it's really quiet, there are some weird things happening. Guys, we're so sorry about this. We are trying to get this to work. Up until, obviously, 2 days ago, Brad and I were going to meet to do this. And now that's clearly not possible. So we had to quickly work out how to do split screen. And now we're hoping this is going to be okay. From this... Go on, Brad. We'll put it down to that, yeah. They'd have to have taken down the entirety of the internet, Brad. But people can't hear you. So, Brad, all I can really do is cut you loose at this point and get on with the quiz. I can't think of another way of doing this unless I just call you up on my phone. The other option is we can get you on another computer. We might see if that can work. So I tell you what, Heather, my beautiful assistant, is going to do that. I am cutting you loose for now.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow. This is so weird.
Wait.
Everybody stay tuned. Everything, it's all up from here, I promise you.
If I don't come back, thank you for tuning in, guys. Stay safe, be kind to each other, and we'll get through this.
Brad, they can't hear you, Brad.
Oh, fuck, all right.
We can hear him now. It works now.
So you guys can hear Brad, but you can't see him? Is that what's happening now?
Yeah, Brad, speak.
Hello, everybody. Can you hear me?
Okay, so you can hear him, but you can't see him.
Are you getting massive feedback or anything? Or is it okay?
There's no feedback. No, I think if we can hear you, we can plow on with that.
Let's do that. I'm happy with that.
We can hear. Everyone's saying StreamYard. We had issues with that while trying to get it to work as well. So clearly we are totally incompetent.
Can we just put out a, can we have some tech support? If there's anyone out there who can help a couple of, you know, early to middle-aged men, you know, we really, really would appreciate your help on the next live stream. If there's anyone out there, any brave new young tech wizards.
Yeah.
Well, any Morpheuses out there, you know.
Let's get on with the quiz, Bradley, because we're now behind schedule and people are here for nothing but quiz.
Right, so, let's quiz it.
The link is going live one more time, so do click it. Has anybody, if anybody hasn't got the link for the quiz, it's just gone by. Click it, click it, click it. Everyone's saying hello to you, Brad. Hi, Brad. We want to get Felicia back. She didn't like the way things were going. I think that's fair enough. But maybe she'll regret it and come back, because the quiz is about to begin.
About to go down.
Okay, right. So, everyone, get over. You don't need to look at us anymore, which is handy too, because you can't even see Brad. And head over to the Google form that we've set up. Just some very quick notes. You don't have to enter your email address if you don't want to. If you do, please do join our mailing list where we send out a monthly email with lots of exciting stuff. But you don't have to join that either. And on that note, just remember, if you want to win, you do have to put your email or else we can't contact you. Let's get on with the first question. Bradley.
Yes.
Do you want to read the first question?
I would bloody love to read the first question.
Okay. So the first round is true or false, general knowledge.
All right. Okay, gang, you ready? Here's the first one, number one on the quiz for you guys. Where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5?
True or false, people? True or false?
I'll repeat that again because that's quite an interesting one. Where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5?
Have we lost Brad again?
Oh, damn.
I'm going to check with my glamorous assistant. Have we lost Brad?
I've got a lag, so I don't know.
Brad's Return of the Brad. Hear but not see. That's cool. That's cool. We have lost the visuals of Brad, sadly. Beautiful as he is. It is sadly just me you're going to be looking at for the remainder of this particular quiz. Right, guys, so question one was, where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5, true or false? Question two, bubble wrap was originally intended to be used as three-dimensional wallpaper, true or false? That bubble wrap was originally intended to be used as 3D wallpaper, true or false? I hope you've got people with you you can confer with.
These are the first few questions, Johnny. Great questions, aren't they, mate?
These are top notch.
Random knowledge here. Is it true, though, Johnny? That's the question.
That's the question. Right, question three, Bradis, do you want to read it?
Yeah. Walt Disney's body was cryogenically frozen on his death.
In case you missed that, Walt Disney's body was cryogenically frozen on his death. True or false?
Yeah, man. I've been watching a lot of Disney Plus because my sister got it and I'm piggybacking the account as of yesterday. So, I'm fucking loving The Mandalorian. It's great. So good. There's only two episodes on there now. I'm going to rewatch them tonight, I think, because they're giving me original Star Wars tingles. So good.
I think we're still going to be doing this quiz at about midnight, so stand by.
Sorry. Question four.
Since 1945, all British tanks have come equipped with tea-making facilities. Is that true or is that false? I should just say from the comments that when we said where's Wally, it could have been where's Waldo.
Where's Waldo? Shit.
I don't know why he's called Waldo in America. If anybody does know, could be worth a point should there be a draw for the win.
Maybe Wally's rude. Is Wally a rude word in America?
It's possible. It's possible.
Like a fanny pack is okay in America, but it sounds a bit dodgy in the UK.
A little bit dodge over here, yeah. So I'll read that question again. Since 1945, all British tanks have come equipped with tea-making facilities. True or false?
That was question four.
Question four. Bradley, you ready for question five?
Yes.
You hit me.
Question five. Frederick Bauer invented the Pringles can. When he passed away in 2008, his ashes were buried in one. Buried in a can, Johnny. Imagine.
So to say that again, Frederick Bauer invented the Pringles can when he passed away in 2008. His ashes were buried in one. Is that true or is that false? I think that's my favourite.
It's great, isn't it?
Yeah. Question six. Denmark uses the most toilet roll per capita in the world. True or false?
Oh, they are such an advanced sort of caring nation, aren't they? Denmark, wow.
I haven't seen any videos of them scrapping for it, so either they've got loads.
They're caring, sharing folk, mate. Okay. And also, there's not that many of them, so I reckon, you know, they're probably not panicking as much. But... In their Scandinavian hideout.
We've had a request to repeat question one again. That's, where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5? True or false?
And say the American version for that?
Where's Waldo books are used in the entry exams for MI5? True or false?
And now in a Floridian accent?
I can't even remember what that is.
I don't know what it is either. No. I don't think there is one.
Right, question seven. In 1939, Hitler's nephew wrote an article called Why I Hate My Uncle. Is that true or false? I'll say that again. In 1939, Hitler's nephew wrote an article called Why I Hate My Uncle. True or false?
I did promise there'd be some sort of Nazi elements to the quiz. So there you go.
There you go. I hope you're all excited by the Nazi element of the quiz.
We're not Nazis, by the way. It's just, it's an interesting sort of... You always seem to get some sort of Nazi question in the pub quiz. Yeah.
I'm not sure that's true, Brad. I'm worried that you're oversensitive to that.
As I said in the podcast previously, it's because of... it's a TV show that I like called Wasted. Anyway, on to the next question.
Question eight. Baby porcupines are called porcupettes. True or false? True or false? Baby porcupines are called porcupettes.
I certainly hope that's true, Johnny.
I'm worried that there's some Darren Brown out there who can see, or rather hear, whether we're lying or not. Because we know the answers, obviously. Although a couple of the questions, when I was marking it up, I'd forgotten which one is correct, because some of them are so ridiculous.
That is true. That is true. Can we just confirm if anyone can hear me at all? Because I'd like to know.
Yeah, no, they still can. They still
can. As far as I can tell, it's great to be here.
We'll know.
Okay, cool.
Right, next question. Brad, go ahead.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Johnny. You've set me up here. The Peter Piper Procession is a yearly competition wherein participants compete to say the Peter Piper tongue twister as fast as possible.
So I'll read that again. The Peter Piper Procession is a yearly competition in which the participants compete to say the Peter Piper tongue twister as fast as possible. Is that true or is that false? We will repeat all questions at the end except for possibly that one. So that was question nine. We'll move on to question 10 and then we'll give you all questions again in quick succession. So question 10. 80s actor Kevin Bacon founded a charitable organisation that rehomes rescued factory farm pigs called Babes.
Babes?
80s actor Kevin Bacon founded a charitable organisation that rehomes rescued factory farm pigs called Babes.
He's got to do something with all that money he's getting off of EE.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he's making a mint, isn't he?
He is.
Right, okay. So that was the first round. We're going to go back and ask all the questions one more time again so that anybody who missed one doesn't miss out on the prize. So, question one was, where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5? True or false? Bubble wrap was originally intended to be used as 3D wallpaper. True or false? Question three, Walt Disney's body was cryogenically frozen after his death. True or false? Question four, since 1945, all British tanks have come equipped with tea-making facilities. 1 second. Cheers. Question five, Frederick Bauer invented the Pringles can. When he passed away in 2008, his ashes were buried in one. Question six, Denmark uses the most toilet paper per capita in the world. True or false? Question seven. In 1939, I love this, Hitler's nephew wrote an article called Why I Hate My Uncle. True or false? Question eight. Baby porcupines are called porcupets. Question nine. The Peter Piper procession is a yearly competition in which participants compete to say the Peter Piper tongue twister as fast as possible. And question 10. 80s actor Kevin Bacon founded a charitable organisation that rehomes rescued factory farm pigs called Babes. So there we go. That is round one. How did we find that? How well do we think we did? Let us know in the comments. While you guys sort that out, I'm just going to show you the beer that I'm currently drinking, which is called Welcome to the Internet by Pressure Drop. It's got lots of dogs on it, which I heartily approve of. The reason I picked this beer is because it says, and I thought this applied well to the quiz, you don't have to be the best, you just have to try your best.
That's a nice sentiment, isn't it?
Yeah, particularly coming from a corgi.
I feel like that's a sort of thing that, was that on the Mighty Ducks or something? Seems like a 1980s feel-good sports movie kind of vibe.
I agree. It does sound. It sounds like something from, maybe Mighty Ducks. What a film that was! Something the coach would have said. Who's in that? It's the brother of the guy who was in Breakfast Club, right?
I thought it was the guy in Breakfast Club.
Oh, is it the guy from Breakfast Club? Emilio Estevez.
Emilio Estevez, I believe he's, isn't he the coach?
He's the coach. Yeah, I think so. There you go. There's a little bit of cultural reference for you. We'll probably leave it there. Because we are famously awful at cultural references.
Yeah.
Jenkins is asking whether the Pressure Drop beer is any good. It is absolutely delicious. Really soft citrus, really orangey kind of orange peel as well. Very nice. Doesn't drink anywhere near 8.5%. So that's dangerous.
Very dangerous.
But yeah, very nice beer. Somebody's accusing somebody of cheating already. Nathan Milbury, put your hand in the air. You're barred. You're barred from Pub Club. Charlie Sheen. Oh, yes, he's the brother of Emilio Estevez. Yes, I think that's right, isn't it?
Tiger Blood Man.
He drinks Tiger Blood.
He's famous for saying he's got Tiger Blood and all that. When he went off the rails and he went to the mental...
Right.
Do you remember that? You know, he got caught in a hotel room. Didn't he barricade himself in a hotel room with strippers or something? And he was going on about Tiger Blood. Oh, it was like a massive meme, like a couple of years ago. It was amazing. Yeah.
It was something about Winner, wasn't it, as well?
So it was like a Songify song about winning.
Yeah.
And it was, I've got Tiger Blood and, winning. Yeah, lots of winning, basically. It's in my head now, but I can't remember the lyrics. It's great.
We've got some people asking for the quiz link. The quiz link is there, just in case you lost it. Nathan Milbury says this is slander. We've got no way to prove either way, Mr. Milbury, so we're just going to have to trust you, aren't we? Guys, if I've put the quiz up again. If you are joining at this point, we might have time to go back and do the do the questions one more time towards the end. But I think for now we're going to move on to round two, because I am absolutely desperate to hear Brad singing. And this is the music round. So we've got... Oh dear, if anybody is on the verge of switching off because you think this is rubbish, I'd probably do it now rather than in 10 minutes. We are now in the club style / Buzzcock style going to sing seven songs. And you have to guess what they are, and then you have to put who wrote it. So we need both the artist and the song's name. And preferably in the comments, a review of what you think of Brad or my rendition of this particular tune. Bradley.
Yeah.
Do you want to start?
Okay.
You reckon you've got this one?
It's got quite a strange intro, I think, from memory, but...
Have you not been boning up and making sure you know how the intros go?
The intro to this one I'm unsure on, but... I'm up for it.
Okay, right.
You can join in if I'm fucking it.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna join if I can work out what you're doing, okay? So this is question 11. We're into the music round. We will hopefully recap round one if you missed out. But for now, question 11. Name that song and the artist who wrote it. Bradley.
Do you want to start it? Because I can't actually remember how it starts, so then I'll join in.
You don't have to start at the start. I think we should go straight into the chorus.
Okay.
What instrument are you choosing?
Vic Reeves, club style.
Okay. Brad, this is so ill-conceived. Are you going for the verse there? Do you know what? The club style is harder than I gave it an impression.
I know,
it gives the impression of. This is much trickier. how would this have gone with no sound? Probably better, actually, Mercy Beers. Probably would have gone better without sound. oh my, there we go. Right, so we're going to move on to question 12. I was about to announce who it was, looking at the answers. Right, you ready, Brad? I'm going to lead this one.
Yeah. This one.
Yeah, it's just occurred to me that if this was actually in front of 250 people, there's no way we would have just done what we just did. We are using the protection of our laptops.
See me, what is our pulling? I'm going to give you this next one because you absolutely nailed this one yesterday when we were talking.
Practicing.
I'll let you do your sort of proper musical stylings.
Do you want to do the vocals over the top of this one?
Okay.
Yeah. We're being asked, are we doing different songs each at the same time?
Is there a lag? Because that would fuck it if there's a big lag.
There is a big lag. Okay, we'll just do it one at a time then. That makes a lot
you
more
do this.
Sense.
You do this one.
Okay. Boom, 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 boom,
That's enough.
Do you reckon that work?
Yeah, that was too good. You're going to show me up now.
That was the whole idea of this, so that I'd look really cool, Brad. I think it's working.
I think you've got to do this next one, and I think just go straight for the chorus. Question 14.
Okay.
Yeah, that was Team Stroke. That's about right. That is about right. I wonder whether we should have just been playing the music, Brad, and just risking the legal issues that we found online about playing music that isn't ours.
I just need to like actually listen to the songs.
You mean you didn't spend all day listening to these seven songs?
Oh, of course I did. Of course I did. The problem is I've got a very visual brain, so all I see is the guys in that music video sticking their heads around a brick wall and like looking at the camera. It's just an amazing video. So I just love that video. It's great.
That's important, Brad.
If no one's realised yet what's going on, these are all quite like apocalyptic titles for song names.
They are all based on apocalyptic. Can you smell toast? Yes, I think if we just go down that avenue and claim that it is a stroke rather than a planned bit of content for subscribers, some of whom are Patreon subscribers and pay for this, maybe that's a better route to go down. This whole idea was conceived while we were in the same room.
It was.
So this has gone slightly off the rails, I think, Brad, isn't it?
It has a little bit.
I wonder whether we should play play the actual music. How would that suit you for the remaining few?
Should we do that?
I reckon so.
What, from the top?
No, from where we were.
Okay, so on to the next one. Or on that one.
For I think the next question, we'll just play the music. I've got it lined up and everything.
Okay, you do that.
Yeah, you ready? So we're going to give you 10 seconds of the actual song on the next one. Can you start doing requests? That wouldn't make a great quiz. So maybe later? So we're going to move on to question 15 and get this music round over with as quickly as possible. This is question 15. Name that song and that artist.
I mean, it's not difficult, is it? Because the words say the name of the song.
People are now suddenly like, no, you should keep going. They've gone from saying you're having a stroke to saying, no, keep doing what you're doing.
Oh, dear.
This is a... Okay, we'll keep singing. We'll say 15, that's on you. That also means we don't have to sing that particular song. And I think Brad needs to do this next one as well.
No, you're doing this one.
You want me to do this one? Okay.
I mean, I can do it if we're going straight into the top bit, I suppose.
Bust out the pan pipe. We should have had pan pipes. That's how we should have done it. That would have been the
next
dream.
Next time.
Okay. All right. So next question. We're going back to singing due to unpopular demand. So question 16 goes... There we go. Yeah, somebody's already reported us for copyright infringement. Thanks, Oscar Bot. There we go. We're back. Back with the club style. We've only got one more to go. It's an absolute banger of a tune. Bradley, take it away. Question 17. There we go. I'd just like to point out we've lost 50 viewers while we were doing the music round. 60. Yes. Make that 60 viewers. Thank you to my glamorous assistant for never letting me underestimate how much people are disliking what I'm producing.
Actually, 65.
There we go. Just keeps going up. Yep. Thanks.
We should have done the beer round before the annoying.
That's probably what we should have done, because we got some comments saying that people aren't drunk enough for this. I'm not sure what level of drunkenness you'd need to be.
What have you been doing all day? You should be getting hammered, surely.
We've got a request to repeat question 17, Brad.
Huh? Sorry, what did you say, mate?
We need to repeat question 17, the last one you just did. Kieran Moritz missed it.
Okay. I think I'm getting better.
I think you are. I think you're learning. I think now that you know the songs, you're doing pretty well.
That's it.
Okay, right. So thank God that's over with. For our next trick, we'll be doing normal ones. The best ones stay. That's right, Dylan.
Question
11. Loads of people asking for 11 again. You are. I don't know. Insatiable people.
I think you should start 11 at the beginning bit.
Well, with the verse.
Yeah.
There you go. Question 11. What is my life? That's not the question. That's what I'm asking myself. I'm asking you what that song was. Oh, my. Right, so we are going to move on to the final round. You'll be glad to know. I'd say that this is our best round.
Oh, yeah.
It's certainly our
most craft beer channel round.
It's our most craft beer channel round. It's also the one that had the most preparation.
Yes.
So bear that in mind. This is what we had in our heads when we started planning this, and then COVID-19 came along and went, hey, all those plans that businesses and you losers on the internet had, forget those. We're getting more requests for questions. We've done 17 many times, okay? Now you're just trolling us. We will not be repeating any more music rounds. We've actually gone up by 10 views. Maybe people thought I'll just come back once it's over with. Question 13. Damn. Okay, you've requested every single song again. I don't think that can happen. We're going to move on to the next round and then work out how to do this. So, if you could scroll down to the final round, which starts at question 18. For those who are worried that you have to know about beer, there's only one question where you might need to. The rest is pretty much guesswork. So, the first five questions are asking you to spot the real beer in a list of four. These are all supposed beer names, one of which is true. So all you have to do is tick the one that you think is actually a beer. So we're going to start with question 18. I'll read them out even though they're already down. Because some of them are ridiculous. So question 18. Which of these beers is a real beer? Indigo tie-dye wolf t-shirt. Orange striped polo neck. Purple plaid shirt. Or skinny jeans and canning machines. I'll read that again for the Darren Browns amongst you trying to read my tone. Indigo tie-dye wolf t-shirt. Orange striped polo neck, purple plaid shirt, skinny jeans, and canning machines. Brad, do you actually know the answers to this, or are you wandering along too?
I think I know that one, and I would just add that I think the actual truth is the one that I would most like to wear.
Oh, there's a clue. There's a clue.
If anyone's a regular watcher, they might have seen me wearing something along these lines.
Guys, it's still requesting 12. Which one was 12? Why is that so popular? Oh, it's a banger. They're all bangers. Apparently we can write great tunes about the end of the world. Right. Question 19. Which of these is a real beer? Turkish Delight Fight, Pitter Bitter, Tarama Salata Non Grata, or Balaclava Baklava? I've actually forgotten which one is a real beer there.
I mean, they're all great band names.
I mean, I'm assuming that these will become beer names eventually?
I think we need to copyright all of them right now. I like Tara Masalata non grata particularly. I think they're all very strong though. I would have them as a hardcore punk band.
All that too. Maybe not Pitter Bitter.
Yeah.
Not so sure about that as a hardcore band name.
No.
Question 20. Which of these is a real beer name? Angry Nerd Chess Club, Professional Paintballer Pills, Water Balloon Fight Club, or Counter-Strike Camper IPA?
Wow.
Shout out to all the guys and girls playing Counter-Strike in the early 2000s rather than doing their homework. If you're a camper, though, screw you.
Yeah, man, it's just not cool camping out, you know? You got to get amongst it.
Yeah.
You're picking people off, like, you know, from some vantage point. It's bullshit.
Even though, from my limited understanding of warfare, you should definitely camp if you are in war. Don't just go running around in alien, jumping up and down to avoid bullets. I'm not sure that really works. You can correct me if I'm wrong if there's anybody who is part of the forces or X-Forces out there.
I'm considering rejoining Xbox Live because I've got to fill my days and evenings with something, Johnny. Now I can't go out in the world.
You're gonna meet all your 16-year-old friends again.
That's a different forum.
Okay, good. Dope. Moving on. So question 21. Which of these is a real beer? A sexy Sasquatch, a beautiful horse, a sessionable sea snake, or an incognito iguana?
Are these all sex moves?
I'm not to my knowledge. Sessionable sea snake. Actually, no, that does work, doesn't it?
I mean, all of them work, to be honest.
Three of them are sex positions. One of them is a beer name. Pick it out.
Okay.
there we go. Right. Question 22 is coming right up. I'm going to give you a couple more seconds. People do seem to be wanting a couple of seconds to guess these. Question 22. Which of these is a real beer name? Dangerously close to stupid amounts of papaya, seriously near to a serviceable pun, a terrible name for a terrible beer, or quickly approaching the lupulin threshold?
I mean, I know I've certainly approached the lupulin threshold on several occasions.
Yeah, we've dropped away from the lupulin threshold a bit. I feel like maybe as West Coast comes back, maybe we will.
Yeah, I've had a couple of hazy nights on the precipice of the lupulin threshold in my past.
Sounds like the start of a sci-fi movie. right, question 23. So the question here is, which of these four is not a genuine bad marketing idea from a brewery? So three of these are actual things that have happened in the beer industry, marketing campaigns or approaches by breweries. One of them is not. One of them I have made up. So which of these is real? Named a brewery after the Manhattan Project, which, if you don't know what that is, that was working out how to make an atomic bomb. Is it named a beer COVID-19 cure? Is it sending satirical pro-gay rights beer to Vladimir Putin? Or is it sending out beers designed to self-destruct after 3 months? I emphasize, three of those are real. Three of them. What a world.
That's interesting, isn't it?
So I'll give you a couple of seconds to think through that while I take a sip, because that one's a doozy. Somebody's actually had the answer to question 22. I look forward to asking you what you thought of it once we've revealed the answers. Oscar, but I didn't say it was easier. I just said it was better. But that's obviously in the eye of the beer holder. Right. Question 24. Another.
Did you say in the eye of the beer holder?
Beer holder. Yeah, I said that. Yeah. It's a gag.
That's nice.
Thanks, man.
I
got it from somewhere.
That, right? That's too good.
right, question 24. three of the next four things I'm going to say are real ingredients used in a commercial beer. One of them is not. I repeat that. Three of these are ingredients that have been used in beer. One of them is not. Is it yeast from your girlfriend's vagina, burger and chips, literally money, or weasel poo?
Oh, blimey.
One of those is not real. The other three are.
I feel like inadvertently, probably all of those things have gone into beer at some point or another.
I'm not sure about that, Bradley. How have burger and chips inadvertently gone into... Well, how have any... Never mind. Why have they really gone in? That's the more important question.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, okay. Question 25. I've got to get this right. Xenoxylophobia is the fear of what? Is it fear of an empty glass, fear of fizzy drinks, fear of inebriation, or fear of fear itself?
Fear of Fear Itself is a great name for a movie.
Surely it is one. I think it's a quote from Harry Potter as well. I think Dumbledore says that at some point.
Okay.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah.
That's definitely a Johnny factoid. Interesting.
I feel I should clarify with the girlfriend's yeast, not specifically yours. I mean, it could be a real thing. So we're moving on to question 26. Beer was invented in which modern country? Is it Iraq, Egypt, Italy, or Peru? I'll say that again. Beer was invented, or perhaps more accurately, discovered in Iraq, Egypt, Italy, or Peru.
So it's historically, where was it found?
Historically, well, I guess I will be even more precise. Where is the earliest record of people drinking beer?
Okay.
So the first known people to have been drinking beer, is that Iraq, Egypt, Italy, or Peru?
Those Peruvians, eh? I reckon they're absolutely on the lash back in the day.
The Aztecs?
Oh.
Could be. Okay, question 27, the last question of the quiz, before I ask you and tell you about the tiebreaker. Question 27, which of these statements is true about IPA? Three of them are false. One of them is true, talking about the origins of the IPA. So, were the original IPAs brewed with more hops than in most pale British beers at the time? Were they brewed stronger to survive the trip to India? Were they the most popular beer style in India at the time? Or does IPA stand for Indian Pale Ale? I was about to say answers on a postcard. Answers in a Google form.
That's a doozy, isn't it, that one? It's going to catch a lot of people out, I reckon.
It's a tricky one. I caught myself out a couple of times trying to make sure that I'd got my history correct.
No Googling that, you lot.
People still asking for question 12. Somebody wants question 25 again. I can read that one. Come on, Johnny. Xenoxylophobia is a fear of what? Empty glasses, fizzy drinks, inebriation, or fear itself.
Imagine being scared of fizzy drinks, Johnny. Soda streams are out of the equation.
Oh, because everyone still uses those.
Oh, they do around my way. I wonder if you could use one of those to carbonate a beer. I suppose you could.
Oh, definitely, yeah. If you've got a lot of time on your hands, for sure.
Yeah.
Right, so I'm going to read out some questions that people need to hear again. I've got a feeling we're going to be singing number 12. Before we do, though, guys, I want you to fill in the tiebreaker. So in the event of a tie, we'll leave it down to judges' discretion. So we've left a tiebreaker in that we can judge. So I want you to tell us what is effectively your desert island beer and why. Obviously, we can't go to desert islands at the moment, so we're saying your perfect self-isolation beer. You can choose what format. Could be keg, can, cask, or bottle. And you have an unlimited supply of it, so don't worry about that. But just tell us your perfect beer, desert island beer forever. And once we've had all the entries, we will get you guys to tell us in the comments as well. So, right, while people are filling in that, what questions do we want again? I'm seeing question one and two are needed again. So question one was, where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5, true or false? Question two was, bubble wrap was originally intended to be used as 3D wallpaper, true or false? And three, Walt Disney's body was cryogenically frozen after his death, true or false? Okay. Asking for 10, 11, and 12 again. This could be fun. Question 10. 80s actor Kevin Bacon founded a charitable organisation that rehomes rescued factory farm pigs called Babes. Should clarify, he doesn't just rescue pigs called Babe. He rescues them and his charity's called Babes.
I don't know how he's not getting in trouble with... you know, the movie people there, Johnny.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's Kevin Bacon, man. He's got some weight, hasn't he? In his gammons. He's got some absolute girth to those gammons.
Goodness. Right, so people want questions 11 and 12. I'm going to come back to those. Question 27, I'm going to read again, and question 28. Question 28 is, of course, the tiebreaker. Question 27, which is the only true statement about the origins of IPA? And the options are there waiting for you to click. So question 11, I'll just quickly do the chorus from 11 and from 12. 11 is... And question 12 is... And if Brad loved me, he'd have been going boodin 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 boodin. That's too late now. That wasn't what. No, okay. So that is the end of the quiz questions. Please get all of your Blue Nose beer reviews. You are not getting 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17 again. I'm flattered that you think our singing is at all acceptable, but not happening. So enter your answers, click submit. We've had 52 entries so far. We're going to wait a little bit longer. While we do that and wait for the final answers to come through and everyone to Google the answers, Brad, what's your desert island beer?
Oh, bloody hell. Maybe... Eddie Topper. Maybe.
So you're gonna get really drunk in self-isolation.
Yes, I am. That's my plan. Maybe Eddie Topper, yeah.
You wouldn't downgrade to a focal banger just to keep things sensible?
Not if I'm in a desolation, isolation spiral of decay. I wanna get all up in my grill with some of that crazy juice.
That is fair, you're not wrong. Good to know. Right, we've had over 100 entries now. That's awesome to see. My desert island beer, possibly be Pale Fire, from the guys at Pressure Drop, possibly Pilsner Urquell. I love that beer, although I'm trying to weigh up whether independence would matter to me on a desert island / in isolation forever.
I didn't consider the fact we could have a tank fresh Pilsner Urquell.
Yeah.
on a tropical, steamy tropical island. That sounds spectacular. Is it crisp and cool and chilled?
It's crisp and cold and mystically just keeps filling up.
Is there a side pour tap that I can decide what kind of pour I want?
Yeah, but the issue is that you're not very good at using it, because, Brad, you're not.
I've got some time on my hands.
You'll learn.
I can figure it out.
Got all the beer in the world to waste, I guess, haven't you? So you'll work it out.
Exactly.
Also, Mlyko pours are delicious anyway.
Aye.
Yeah. It probably would be Pilsner Raquel for me, if I'm being entirely honest. Although I'd say there are lots of amazing independent breweries in the Czech Republic who I might go for. Maybe Unyatitsje. I'd go for some sideboards of that, because that was delicious stuff.
That's good stuff.
Right, we're going to dive into the comments quickly, catch up with you guys, and then we'll be giving the answers to the quiz. And we're going to hopefully be able to give you the winner tonight, but it might have to be once we go offline. We might have to do a quick bit of marking and a quick bit of judgy deciding if there's a tie break, in which case we'll email the winners and announce the winner at some point on our YouTube channel so everyone knows. So Carlos Velez says he agrees on Heady Topper, but Andy Topper says he prefers Focal Banger. I'm also in that camp. I think I prefer Focal Banger, although the best beer by The Alchemist is Luscious, their Imperial Stout, in my opinion. Richard Smith, Maple Peak and Imperial Stout. That is a strong Desert Island beer choice. Jack Ashman was drinking Sea Salt and Chili Stout from Anspach and Hobday. I hate chili beers, but I'm looking for one that will change my mind. So let me know what you think of it.
Sea Salt and Chili Stout, is that?
Yeah, it's pretty bold, but I'm into it.
That's a crazy combo. Interesting. I need to try that. I haven't tried it.
I saw it. Where was it? Adam Keyworth said Sonoma from Track in Manchester, if you don't know those guys. It's a 3.8% sort of New England pale, and it's bloody marvellous. I'd agree. That's absolutely delicious. Zinner Beer from Brussels Beer City. Yeah, Zinner Beer's great. Yeah, Zinnebeer or Taris, that's a tricky one from Delasen. Bell's Too Hearty, a great choice. Chubbles, blimey, James. Chubbles. Orval would change the tech. Yeah, Orval, that'd be fun. And you could age some and get different beers all the time. Steady Rolling Man, that would be right up there as well. Beer Gorilla hates chili beers as well. I find it interesting drinking spicy stuff, but I also remember that the Aztecs, who are from Mexico, I apologise, they had chili chocolate, and I remember having some of that and loved it, so I apologise. Pliny the Younger, sure, Pliny is the bollocks.
Yeah, that's a good shout, actually.
Somebody's having a kutch at the Brave Sir Robin Hatch. I love that pub. Tarasville Day. Rothouse Pills is a great shout. I love that lager. Marble Pint on Cask. Direct from the Arch. How's that going to work on a desert island? I mean, it has to work because it's a mythical island, but you're pushing the boundaries of imagination there. Julius, Jody says, 100%. That would be right up there for me. I think it's easily their best beer. Lots of people would disagree with me, but hey, that's their one. Thornwich Green Mountain. Yeah, good. Good, you're all full of solid beers. A lot of IPA, it seems to be. I kind of feel like I'd want lager if it was all I could have forever. No, maybe it would be IPA. It's a tough question, that's why we picked it. We've now had 133 entries. If you are yet to enter, you're running out of time. I'm going to give you another 2 minutes before the cutoff, and then I will start giving the answers from that cutoff. You can't just be sat there filling it in with the answers. I can see them as they come in, and I will be able to cut you off. You supposedly clever dick. Siren Broken Dream, lovely beer. Glyn says, unfortunately, I don't get all these beers here. Where are you, Glyn? Let us know where you are, and let us know what you would pick. I've missed it in the comments because they're coming through thick and fast. Where the Crispy Boys at? Exactly, Oscar. IPL is the compromise. Not a bad shout. back when IHL from Camden was good, that was one of my favourite beers, and now it's a very, very different beer. It's called something different now. It's called something awful. What's it called? Show Off. How's that aspirational and inviting for people? If you buy it, you instantly become a show off. That does not work. Steam Whistle Pilsner. That's everywhere on my Twitter. And I've never tried it. It's Canadian, I think, right? Yeah, I think it's Canadian. Tegan's Air Hells, great choice. See, now all the lagers are coming in. Now they're all coming in. Can you view your answers? That's a good question. I think you might be able to go back and check. Maybe go back to the link. I'll post the link one more time. And it might have what you put in the first time, but I'm not 100% sure. So apologies for that. Right, so we've had no more entries. So that must mean we've got everyone that wants to enter. Thank you so much for entering. It's been an absolute pleasure having you guys compete in this very well organized, not at all thrown together after the lockdown happened pub quiz. Brad, are you still with me? I've just been chatting forever.
Yeah, I've been only chat, man. I mean, I just feel a little bit bummed that people didn't get to see my face. And, you know, it's kind of weird. Hopefully next time we'll get it together more and it'll be a more cohesive split-screen affair. Or hopefully, you know, I'll actually get to see a beautiful face, mate, in reality. Wouldn't that be lovely?
It is a good face, isn't it?
You know, like 2 weeks ago, man, like, what a different world we lived in. We were judging at a beer competition, a beer awards, traveling the country. You know, social distancing just about, but you know, absolutely loving life and getting out and about in amongst it. I think stuff like this is going to become more important to people. Hopefully, you know, we're about if you want to chat with us. And hopefully we can make this more interactive. If anyone's got any great ideas about how we can make this more interactive, I'd love to hear it. We've struggled to have just the two of us split screen, but you know, with all this stuff like House Party app that's coming online now, I mean, it'd be great to have people phoning in. I'd love that.
Yeah, so we're going to do a bit more research and try and get this a little bit better next time. I'm sure we can go back through the comments and see what you guys said we should have been using instead. So we'll definitely give that a try and see if that's easier to do. We apologize for you losing F. But yeah, thanks so much for joining us. But it's not the end yet. We've still got to go through the answers. And then we'll have a quick chat at the end and see if you guys want to do this one or two or three more times again, where we can tweak it. So let's start with round one. Brad, do you want to... Give the question and the answer for question one.
give me a second.
All right, I'll do question one. You chip in when you can. So question one.
I can help you. Sorry. I can do this. Okay, can everybody still hear me? Question one. Where's Wally books are used in the entry exams for MI5? And I'll do that in American as well. Where's Waldo books are used in the entry exams for MI5? And that is a massive lie.
That's a lie, I'm afraid.
Sorry. I mean, I think they should be used because, you know, if you can spot them that quickly where Wally is, I think you're going to be able to pick out, you know, a needle in a haystack. I think that's a quality.
The thing you're missing is that the other spy is probably not going to be dressed in a red and white striped jumper. That's where that falls down.
That's true.
Question two was bubble wrap was originally intended to be used as 3D wallpaper, and that is true.
That is true.
Imagine how fun a room would be with bubble wrap on the wall.
Yeah. What do you mean? I've got it all over my house, mate. Have you not noticed? I've got foil underneath it to keep the government out, and then I've got bubble wrap to keep me from you know, hurting myself. Great. Love it.
Question three, brothers.
Walt Disney's body was cryogenically frozen upon his death. Now, this is interesting. This is actually false. And this blows my mind because I thought that was real. His body was actually cremated in Glendale, California. The rumour was likely started because the president of the Cryogenic Society of California, he told the Los Angeles Times that Walt Disney Studios had inquired about the process. So I think that was a little bit of, marketing hype on that guy's part.
Yeah.
But it's a total fallacy that he was frozen.
I wonder how many other people he's just gone, yeah, they asked, like, I don't know, JFK, he asked,
Exactly. But I mean, in my mind, there's this cultural phenomenon where you believe something's true. I can't remember what it's called. Another time. But Disney had made two films called Frozen 1 and Frozen 2. There you go.
I don't think that was a hint. There's nothing in the plot.
No.
Question 4. Since 1945, all British tanks have come equipped with tea-making facilities. Apparently that is true.
No way.
Apparently that is true. And it's not just tanks, like it's other forms of transport for transport that you're going to be stuck in for a long time. Apparently they all have tea-making facilities.
I guess all that means is just a way to heat water, right?
Yeah, so I mean, it would be used for other things, like to cook like rations and stuff like that, I'm sure. But you can make tea in a tank. Question 5, brothers.
Frederick Bauer invented the Pringles can. When he passed away in 2008, his ashes were buried in one. That's true.
That's true, motherfuckers.
You've got to love that, the commitment of that man.
Yeah.
He came up with that design, and he thought, you know what? I'm a bloody genius. And for all eternity, I'm so confident in myself, I'm going to be buried in my own invention. did you know that a Pringles can, you can use that to amplify a Wi-Fi signal? Did you know that?
I did not know that, Brad.
The foil in it. If you hold it in a, if you can rig it up to your home network, or I believe some sort of mobile phone thing as well to get a better signal, MacGyver style.
Yeah.
Because it's aluminium or something wrapped inside it. Anyway,
my favourite thing about that fact is, I wish they'd scattered his ashes, because then they'd have been scattering away, and then they'd have got to the bottom of it, and they'd have been going, like, trying to get the last bit, putting their hand in, like everyone is with the crisps, and that image makes me chortle. Anywho, question 6. Denmark uses the most toilet roll per capita in the world. That is false.
Oh.
It's actually America.
It is America, and it's closely followed by Germany, I believe, from our...
Yeah, clean living nation, I believe.
Yeah.
We were trying to choose a country very carefully to tell this lie, and we picked Denmark because we just thought they'd probably be very conservative and sustainable in their use of toilet roll.
Exactly.
Yeah. Right. Somebody says, let's meet on Zoom next time. Zoom can only have 100 people. Given our performance tonight, maybe there will only be 100 people, so maybe that'll work. Question 7. In 1939, Hitler's nephew wrote an article called Why I Hate My Uncle. Is that true or false, Brad?
It's only bloody true, mate.
It's true. I feel like he didn't really need to write that article. Like, people could understand why he might hate Hitler.
To give that a bit of background, I don't know his name. But he emigrated to America. He served in the American Navy and settled in Long Island. So he wanted to distance himself from his uncle.
Who wouldn't?
Fair enough.
Let's not go into it. Some people didn't. Question 8. Baby porcupines are called porcupets. And that is true. And it's wonderful.
That's too cute.
I love that. Porcupets.
It was true.
Question 9. Do you want to try this or shall I?
The Peter Piper Procession is a yearly competition wherein participants compete to say the Peter Piper tongue twister as fast as possible. Johnny, is that true?
It's pulse. No, it's false.
It's false! It is false.
It is.
Although false. I think we should probably make it a thing now.
Sorry, I've just read an amazing comment. Hitler's nephew wanted to distance himself, but then gave one of his sons the middle name Adolf. Is that true?
Blimey.
This is why we're here, for this kind of knowledge. I hope that's true. but yeah, sorry, getting back to where we were. Where are we? Question 10. 80s actor Kevin Bacon founded a charitable organisation that rehomes rescued factory farm pigs called Babes. Of course that's false. That was us running out of ideas. Much like Kevin Bacon has. Yeah, so that is the end of the general knowledge round. I'd love to know how you guys think you did. I can see many people saying they're losing. So if everyone's saying they're losing, don't worry about it, because that means you could still be winning. Somebody said solid name. I hope that's to do with Babes, not to do with Adolf. Right. The music round. Let's blitz through these before they start asking for more requests. Question 11. The answer was REM, End of the World as We Know It. That is despite our best efforts to make it sound like anything else. Answer 12 was The Police, Don't Stand So Close to Me. Can you see the theme we're going for? Beatles is the answer to question 13, Come Together. The opposite of the theme. 14 was The Bee Gees, Staying Alive. Brad, give us a ha-ha.
Ha-ha, ha-ha, ha-ha.
So breathy, ASMR style. Question 15, Destiny's Child, Survivor. Question 16, Eric Carmen, Who Knew It Was a Guy, All By Myself. And then question 17, Tiffany, I Think We're Alone Now.
That's my favourite one to murder, actually.
I'm trying to get it started again through OBS.
Okay.
It's working.
Is it come back?
You're back. Talk.
Can everyone hear me again?
Go. You're good.
Okay, I think we might be back. My computer momentarily broke there. It completely crashed, and usually that means the end of the feed, but I think we might be back. You might have heard lots of us discussing what we were going to do in the eventuality that we couldn't get the feed back.
I said we should kill everybody because we're definitely wrong.
This has been a fucking roller coaster, I'm not going to lie. After this, I'm just going to lie down in a road. So, we are back. We're getting some viewers coming back. We were at 200, we're now down at 45. But we're so glad that so many of you stuck around. Thanks for continuing to chat. My fiance Heather's done a wonderful job of just chatting away and keeping you guys believing we were coming back.
We're back to 128 people.
There you go. They're all coming back. Thank you so much. I believe this has been one of the weirdest hour and a half of my life, but we're back. My computer could conk out again at any moment. So before I continue reading the final results of the pub quiz, let me just say I love you. Thanks for sticking around and thanks for coming on our stream. You guys and girls are all absolute legends. I'm just going to open up our pub quiz answer sheet and then I will continue where we left off. So, yeah, we just finished the music round. We were just talking absolute nonsense, and we were about to get into the final round, which was the commercial beer round. So I'm just going to dig that out, and we will be away again. Craft Beer Channel, powered by Heather TM. There you go.
Yeah.
Let's put a smile on her face, because she's had a more miserable time than I have, I think. Right, okay, here we go. Just going to, I've still got beer, but there's going to be another one cracked in a second. Right. So here we go, the answers. So what did you say, Brad?
Richard Smith said, Brad and Johnny, do you do children's birthday parties?
We do not do children's birthday parties, nor should we. We could do live ones if... No, we couldn't do live ones either. I don't know where I'm taking that. Right, okay. Answers to the final round, guys. So, question 18, we were going to be asking you... we were asking you which of these beers are actually real. Question 18, was it indigo tie-dye wolf t-shirt, orange stripe polo neck, purple plaid shirt, or skinny jeans and canning machines? I believe skinny jeans and canning machines is soon going to be a beer by Polly's Brew. The answer was indigo tie-dye wolf t-shirt, which was by Verdant in collaboration with an American brewery, which I've forgotten in all the panic, but was part of the Rainbow Project, which they do every year, collaborating with American breweries. Well done if you got that one. Question 19. Was the real beer Turkish Delight Fight, Pitter Bitter, Tarama Salata Non Grata, or Balaclava Baklava? I can incredulously tell you that it was Balaclava Baklava, which was a pastry beer by Other Half from last year. Question 20. Which of these is a real beer? Was it Angry Nerd Chess Club, Professional Paintballer Pills, Water Balloon Fight Club, or Counter-Strike Camper IPA? It was Water Balloon Fight Club, which I believe is a monkish beer.
Somebody drank that.
Somebody made it, and I'd love to know, yeah, if somebody drank that, and whether it had anything to do with balloons.
Do I sound like a dog, you said?
Sounds like a what?
Do I sound like a Dalek?
You're sounding all right to me, but is somebody saying you do sound like a Dalek? I'm loving these comments, just like yes or no, or damn, I missed that. This is a lot of fun to watch. Right, next answer. So question 21, which of these is real beer? A sexy Sasquatch, a beautiful horse, a sessionable sea snake, or an incognito iguana? It was a beautiful horse, which is a beer by Cloudwater. And it did indeed have a beautiful horse on the can, to be fair to them. Question 22, which is a real beer? Dangerously close to stupid amounts of papaya, seriously near to a serviceable pun, a terrible name for a terrible beer, or quickly approaching the lupulin threshold. The answer was dangerously close to a stupid amount of papaya, which was Tuol from Denmark, Copenhagen at the time, now less so. How are people doing? Would love to know. How did you do in that round? I must confess, I've only drunk one of those beers, which is poor form for us, really. We need to track some of them down because they're, depending on your point of view, either terrible or awesome names. Which one leaps out as a tasty beer to you, whether it's real or not, Brad?
What was the Sasquatch one? I quite like that vibe.
A sexy Sasquatch.
Sexy, that's me. That's me all over.
A sexy Sasquatch. That is quite... Yeah, maybe that's where I was going with that subconsciously.
Yeah, I think so.
Right, question 23. So this was, which of these is not a real marketing campaign by a brewery? So was it a brewery named after the Manhattan Project, a beer named COVID-19 Cure, a beer that was a satirical pro-rights beer and was sent to Vladimir Putin, or a beer designed to self-destruct after 3 months? The latter is the fake one. No beers are designed to self-destruct after 3 months, but several of them do, particularly the fruited gosards that are known to explode due to re-fermentation in the can.
What was Fruit Dog had that one that was about Born to Die? Remember that?
Born to Die was their version of Stone's Drink By or Enjoy By. So
yeah.
beer that they were basically saying after 3 months it won't taste the same. But it didn't explode after 3 months, just to be clear.
No.
The others are all incredibly, they are real. I think it was a Texan brewery, was called Manhattan Project. COVID-19 Cure is, of course, an IPA released by a stupid brewery. And BrewDog sent a satirical pro-gay rights beer to Vladimir Putin after he, I think they passed some laws to make homosexuality illegal. Question 24, which of these is not an ingredient in a commercial beer? Yeast from your girlfriend's vagina, burger and chips, literally money, or weasel poo? The answer is yeast from your girlfriend's vagina, but only because that beer never got released. It was a brewery, it was a concept, and they crowdfunded and thankfully never got the money to release that awful idea. That's the world we're living in, folks, right now.
It's a bit disturbing, isn't
it? Yeah, I mean, a horribly judged, terrible idea that thankfully never got off the ground. It did get £1,000 of investment of, I think, the £25,000 they were looking for. I don't want to know who the people were that put £1,000 in. Question 25. Senescilophobia is fear of an empty glass, fizzy drinks, inebriation, or fear itself. It is, in fact, the fear of empty glass. It's a genuine thing. I did Google to see if this was a thing, but I think, I don't know, some way the light refracts or something about it can make people feel very uncomfortable, much like fingers down a blackboard, stuff like that. Obviously, there are less mild forms, which is just really thirsty people. Yeah, it could be just that. Yeah, alcoholism, basically. Question 26. Where's the first recorded example of people enjoying beer? Was it Iraq, Egypt, Italy, or Peru? It was, in fact, what is now known as Iraq, but back then was Sumeria, which covered some areas of Iraq, what became Persia and what became Iraq. And then question 27, our final question. This was a doozy, and it will probably upset some people. Which of these is a true statement about the origins of IPA? Was it that it had more hops than most pale British beers at the time? Was it generally brewed stronger to survive the trip to India? Was it the most popular beer style in India? Or does it stand for Indian Pale Ale? The answer is it had more hops than most pale British beers at the time. It wasn't really strong to survive a trip to India. That's what the hops were doing. It was not the most popular beer style in India. Actually, milds and porters were probably more popular at the time over there. And then it's actually India Pale Ale. So that was a real, that was a stumbling block I put in there to trip some people up.
Nicely done.
Did I trip you up, Brad?
Not quite, but I mean, some of those were really tempting, weren't they?
They were. Bacchus Manon says that some beer made from yeast from models has gone on sale in Poland. That's very disappointing. Don't buy it. Boycott it. Evil Twin Big Ass Money Stout. Yes, that is what we were referencing when we said that a beer had been made with money. It was also made with frozen pizza. That beer, the story was that Evil Twin liked to make beers with the local ingredients or what the country's famous for. He sat down with Mike Murphy of Lervig to say, what's Norway famous for? What produce? And Mike said, we're famous for being rich and eating a lot of frozen pizza. So they made a beer with that.
Remember Nashville, Johnny?
Nashville, yeah, exactly. We had a load of frozen pizza and we're in a very nice house.
Yeah.
So there you go. So guys, we're going to mark up those results and we're going to tell you who won. We'll email the winner and announce it on social media and on our YouTube community tab, which is where you can have conversations with us, and we post stuff almost daily just saying what we're up to, what's happening, and posting to other cool stuff on the internet. So we'll announce it there. Before we go, or before the computer crashes, or before somebody starts singing again, I'd love to talk about some people doing amazing stuff right now during the COVID-19 crisis. People raising money for good causes, for the NHS, for stuff like that. And I'd love to hear from you guys stuff that other people are doing so that hopefully I can write about it in the stories that I'm writing right now. So in the comments, tell me the amazing stuff that other people, other breweries, pubs, distributors, anyone in the beer industry is doing for the world. And I'd like to give a shout out to BrewDog. for their hand sanitizer, and they're also using their now defunct delivery drivers to deliver school dinners to people working from home or unable to afford food now that their kids can't be sent to school and get those free dinners. Breweries, so many breweries giving donations to the NHS in the form of free beer. If you go to Cloudwater, Fierce, lots of them are, you can buy a tiny donation on their website, and once they reach a large enough donation, they send a box to a nominated doctor, nurse, backstaff person, paramedic, all those kind of people. Very, very worthy stuff. If you know a brewery that's struggling, please point them in the direction of crowdfunder.co.uk, because they can use the crowdfunding services that they have for free there to do what's called pay it forward. So you can basically buy beer in advance. So you could say, you could buy like a bar tab for 30 quid that you'll get your beer in a couple of months when the pubs or the breweries reopen, but you pay for it now, and that helps their cash reserves to pay for their bills, their rent, their business rates, all that kind of stuff. Already great stuff coming through on the comments. Adnams making hand sanitizer in their distillery, that's awesome. Great to hear. Yeah, Pressure Drop are giving discounts to customers nominated by their consumer customers, so that's absolutely awesome. Shout out to Heather, she's donated a lot of time this evening and been amazing when the shit hit the fan multiple times. Maybe more times than usual, Brad, or about the same?
Well, I think more than usual.
More than usual.
Not visual anymore.
It wasn't quite the night where every time we said okay, we lost internet connection because okay Google thought we were asking it a question, but it's come close to that.
That was fun, though.
Was it fun?
Like, it was like a sort of Japanese game show, not to say okay.
Yeah, that does sound like a Japanese game show. So, yeah. Green King have been making sink cleaner. Burn Oscar Bot. BrewDog were offering an NHS discount. Yeah, I mean, it's fun to hate BrewDog, and BrewDog have done lots of stuff that we should be critical of, but man, they have stepped up in this crisis and been amazing. Fuggles in Tunbridge, great bar. You can buy a beery gift for NHS frontline workers. That's awesome. CERN Abbas Brewery, I don't know where that is, but apparently they're helping as well. So please, guys, first rule to support independent retailers. They're the guys that are being really screwed over by this. They don't have the cash flow. They don't have the margins to survive what's happening at the moment. So please support them. And the second rule is, if people are giving back, if people are supporting charities, supporting health service professionals, key workers, please, please do support them as much as you're able to. I obviously know this could be a really tough time if you're a freelancer or a zero-hours worker or a contractor, or you could have lost your job as a result of this. So please look after yourself first financially and help out where you can. But yeah, support your locals and give where you can generously. And of course, self-isolate, keep social distancing and stay safe. The more isolated we are for now, the shorter it's going to last, I hope. So yeah, do bear that in mind. Any messages from you, Bradman?
I would just say, you know, in these times, we need to all come together. We need to be a little bit kinder. We need to stay safe. We need to be more compassionate. We need to ask how our fellow man is doing. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's not all about money and what you've got, but it's about making sure everyone's okay after we come out of this. And we'll come out of this the other side. We just need to make sure that everyone comes out with us.
Yeah.
And that means that, you know, stuff like the Craft Beer Channel, it's going to get a bit flaky. But that ain't the end of the world. It's not the end of the world. You know, we'll all come out of this. We'll run through this, guys. We love you. And just stay safe, guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
What a hippie, someone said. Yeah, I am a bit of a hippie.
So, yeah, guys, thank you so, so much for understanding everything that's happened tonight. It's been a bit of a nightmare, but we've had a lot of fun, and I hope you guys have too. We're going to look at a way of making this more professional and make sure that it works. And we'll do it again for sure if we're confident that we can make it work a little bit smoother. But in the meantime, stay safe, enjoy some beers, be good to each other, and stay 2 meters apart and keep washing those hands. We love you guys, and we'll see you on Wednesday for another upload, and in a couple of weeks, maybe for live.
bye bye.